The knowledge powers, knowledge power is powered by, can you guess? Technology and innovation. Technology and innovation is powered by, I can develop technology, innovation I can have, money I need, isn't it? Technology and innovation powered by resource investment. Resource investment powered by return on investment. All management experts will know, return on investment. Now return on investment powered by revenue. How much you earn? Revenue is powered by volume and repeat sales. Volume and repeat sales powered by customer loyalty to the product. Customer loyalty is powered by quality value of products. Quality and value of products powered by employee productivity and innovation. Employee productivity, innovation, your website. Employee productivity is powered by employee loyalty. Employee loyalty is powered by employee satisfaction. Now employee satisfaction is powered by working environment. Working environment is powered by management innovation. Management innovation is solved by creative leadership. Where do I start? I started economic development, I landed to creative leadership. So for success, the message we want to give you, for success in all mission, it is essential to have creative leaders. Every field, politics also with creative leaders, science also, everywhere. Creed and also, creative leadership means the exercise. What is the meaning? Creative leadership means the exercising. The vision to change the traditional role from the commander to coach. Creative leader is not a commander, he is a coach. Or she is a coach. Manager is not a manager, she is not a manager. Manager to mentor. From director to delegator, from one who demands respect to one who facilitates self-respect. For enhancing the enterprise value, we need a large number of creative leaders throughout the country. Every field. The teacher who is teaching should be a creative leader. The family man, head of the family, or head of the lady, the creative lady, creative father, creative mother. So Fred, finally I would like to conclude. How do you conclude? Qualities of leadership. Finally I said creative leadership. How do you establish the quality of the leadership? Friends, I have seen by myself, my friend Karnik also, you are aware of it. I have seen three dreams which taken shape as a vision, mission, realization. What is space program? I worked there for 20 years, space program. The first India satellite launch vehicle, my team worked on that, we succeeded. Space program is an Indian Space Research Organization. Second is Agni program for DRDO, Defense Research Development Program. It reached 2,000 kilometers, we are very happy, becoming a national mission. Third one, what is called PURA. This you may not have about it. PURA means providing urban amenities rural area, becoming a national mission. It's going to become a big national mission. Of course, these three programs succeed in the midst of many challenges and problems. I have worked in all these three areas. I would like to convey to you, young fellows and experienced people, what I have learned on leadership from these three programs. Number one, I learned leader must have a vision. Day-to-day problem he will not handle. He must have a vision 20 years. Vikram Sarabhai, when he is 70s, he can imagine there will be a geosynchronous orbit. We have to have hundreds of transponders. Today it is there. So leader must have a vision. Leader must have a passion to accomplish the mission, like our metro, Delhi Metro. Metro man, he will have a passion to accomplish the mission. Leader must be able to travel in the unexplored path. All leaders throughout the world, successful leader, unexplored path. You see this light? Just look up. Don't look down. Look up the light. Now, whom do you remember when you see the lighted bulb? Whom do you remember? Thomas? Alva Edison, you remember? That guy, when was a young fellow, he was using oil lamp and candles. And he came up across that, you know. And electricity, how to generate. Of course, before him, the discovery was there. But he used the electricity to make this. When the telephone bell rings, whom do you remember? Alexander Graham Bell. You know how he discovered Alexander Graham Bell, do you know? I went to his university and in Ireland and in Scotland and Edinburgh University. There they told me a story. The story is, as a young boy, he cannot communicate his mother and wife. So he wanted a device, Alexander Graham Bell. That device, he made a big device. He can communicate loudly to his mother and wife. But that became a telephone. Now all of you have got one telephone. India has got 900 million telephones. Isn't it? 900 million fellow, nine out of billion, 900 million people have got. So I am saying, you must be able to travel in unexplored path. All these people, they travel unexplored path. Leader must know how to manage success and failure. Easy. Success management, the easiest thing to do in life. Everybody is happy. But failure occurs. Failure, I have seen, my first lodge was a failure. And the failure occurred, you have to learn and learn, learn. And you should not become the captain of the problem. Captain of the situation. You should become the captain of the problem, defeat the problem, and succeed. This is what I learned. When a failure occurs, you have to become captain of the problem, defeat the problem, and succeed. So, leader must have courage to take this every day in a project program. Hundreds of decisions you have to take. Some good, mad also, bad also. But you have to take decision. Have the courage. And then leader should have a nobility in management. Nobility in management. Every action leader should be transparent. Leader should work with integrity, succeed with integrity. One message, all young fellows, can you carry today? One message, I will work with integrity and succeed with integrity. Then India will become prosperous. Then everything possible. So, one great quality we should acquire, I will work with integrity and succeed with integrity. Friends, India should transform the economical degradation by year 2020. That means our citizens can live in green. What does it mean? India 2020, another 5 years. How will India look like? According to me, that means our citizens can live in a green, clean environment without pollution. Having prosperity without poverty. Peace without fear of war. And a happy place to live for all citizens of the nation. This is my dream. I am sure the eighth dimension of creative leadership, which I talked just now, will be foundation for our talented human power that will transform India into performing nation. India into performing nation. Indeed, India Habitat Center, the India Habitat Center, great designer has done this. India Habitat Center can play a major role in this transformation by equipping the nation in multiple fields the best human power with great quality of what can I give? I will work with integrity and succeed with integrity. What can I give? What is the opposite of what can I give? What can I take? That's a dangerous one. What can I take? Dangerous one. So what can I give? Repeat with me. What can I give? So I will work with integrity and succeed with integrity. And what can I give? If you carry this message, my job is over. So once again, let me greet all of you. My best wishes to all the members of the India Habitat Center and others success in their mission of providing the best talent who will use their ideas, mind power for better India, better world. God bless you, our friends.